नमस्ते. ओह गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा. गुड मॉर्निंग. सो हाउ आर यू ऑल? ऑल फाइन? डूइंग ग्रेट? दैट्स गुड. ओके. व्हाट हैपेंड इज माय वॉइस इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल? कैन यू हियर मी क्लियरली? Okay. All of you, let's start today's prayer. Itni shakti hame dena data. Okay. All of you. Can we go for this? Good morning, Abhinav. Good morning. Yeah. Namaskar, beta. Okay. Let's start. All of you, join your hands, close your eyes. You can turn on your camera.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा. टर्न ऑन योर कैमरा.
कैन यू सी माय कैमरा मैम?
ओके. यस राइट. ओके ऑल ऑफ यू जॉइन योर हैंड्स क्लोज योर आईज. ओके लेट्स स्टार्ट. इतनी शक्ति हमें देना दाता. ओके. इतनी शक्ति हमें देना दाता, मन का विश्वास समझो रहो ना. इतनी शक्ति हमें देना दाता, मन का विश्वास समझो रहो ना. हम चले नेक रस्ते पे, हमसे भूल कर भी कोई भूल हो ना. इतनी शक्ति हमें देना दाता, मन का विश्वास कमजोर होना. दूर अज्ञान के हो अंधेरे, तू हमें ज्ञान की रोशनी दे. हर बुराई से बचते रहे हम, जितनी भी दे भली जिंदगी दे. बैर होना किसी से किसी का, भावना मन में बदले की होना. हम चले नेक रस्ते में, हमसे भूल कर भी कोई भूल होना. इतनी शक्ति हमें देना दाता, मन में विश्वास. I forgot the line. What is this? What is the line? Line?
Man ka vishwas kamzor hona.
Yeah. Man ka vishwas kamzor hona. See, this is a beautiful prayer. Okay. In this prayer, we pray to God so that we can be strong enough to face anything. Okay. And we should feel same for everyone. Right. All of you. I hope you have spent your Sunday nicely. Okay, enjoyed. Okay, let's see whatever message you have sent me. Autocar barrier project got first view. Okay, Krishna, that's great. 1K view. That's great, nice. Congratulations, beta. Okay, next is Agam is saying that I have done crazy experiment. Okay, I will listen.
Yeah.
You should not shout. You should be polite in talking, okay? Tell me
hello,
what happened. Yes, hello.
Ma'am, Congo. Ma'am. Ma'am, Congo. आपको वो certificate मिला ना good teacher का.
Congo, it's congratulations. Thank you so much, beta. Thank you. Because of you all, okay. Because of you all.
मैंने तो late देखा था ना, मेरा नाम मिलन सिनोदिया. मैंने late देखा था ना इसलिए, क्योंकि है ना मेरे mobile में मैं game खेल रहा था. कल भी late आया था ना इसलिए.
ओके मैया.
ओके बेटा, यू शुड स्पीक इन इंग्लिश. बेटा यू शुड स्पीक इन इंग्लिश. ओके या फाइन. थैंक यू सो मच रिधि. मोस्ट ऑफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी विश्ड मी. सी इट्स ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ यू ऑल. ओके आई रिसीव दैट मीन आई गॉट द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू टीच यू. दैट्स माय व्हाट यू कॉल लक दैट यू स्टूडेंट्स आर विथ मी. ओके थैंक यू सो मच एवरीवन. या थैंक यू थैंक यू. ओके so today we are going to complete listening test. I'm going to read the listening part two times ओके फर्स्ट टाइम आई विल रीड आई विल गिव यू 2 मिनट्स टाइम टू कम्प्लीट दैट टास्क आफ्टर दैट आई विल रीड द सेम लिस्निंग पार्ट अगेन ओके एंड यू हैव टू करेक्ट इट ओके सो दिस वुड बी लिस्निंग पार्ट आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कम्प्लीट क्वेश्चन आंसर डिस्कशन वी विल गो फॉर द समरी ऑफ द चैप्टर ओके अगस्त्य you wanted to say something please tell me so that I can start the class
what ma'am I mean what ma'am I don't want to say anything
Agastya you said that you have some crazy experiment
yeah ma'am I will send you link later on in the 8 rocking star group
okay listen I haven't got your letter yet I haven't received your letter yet what happened
I don't know ma'am I have sent into the post office and now I don't know where it has reached
ma'am I have
because
also sent
been... let's see okay so here I'm going to read for you the listening part all of you open page number 46 I think 43 or 46.
Ma'am, you will tell that to get extra knowledge about the Chilika Lake, and you will ask on Monday, one by one.
See, you receive that homework. That, okay, you have to make a video clip for it. Then you have to record your video. You have to give your introduction. Then you will talk about Chilika Lake. Okay. So by Tuesday evening, everybody has to send me the recorded video. Okay, fine.
Okay.
If you will not send, you can send me today also. If it is already done, you can send me today. But Tuesday evening is the last time to submit. After that, I will not receive anyone's video. Okay, I will give mark accordingly only. If you not send me before Tuesday, okay, you will get 0. That's it. Okay, here is your listening part. All of you listen very carefully. I will read the listening for 2 times. Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? We regret to inform you that the cyclonic weather in Bhubaneswar has caused several flights to get delayed. National Airlines Flight 999, Bhubaneswar to Kolkata, which was scheduled for departure at 7:30 from gate number A16. Is now scheduled to depart at 10:30 from gate number A4. Somebody
has.
Mobile तेरा सुंदर है बेटा I know. Okay. Sahara Airlines flight 222 Bhubaneswar to Mumbai scheduled to departure at 11:30 from gate number N8 is now scheduled to depart at 2 o'clock. Deccan Air flight 555 New Delhi to Kolkata via Bhubaneswar is delayed by more than 5 hours. We'll let you know the expected time of arrival in short while. Please check the arrival and departure boards for more specific information and update on individual flights. For passengers who will miss connecting flights, please go to the customer service desk of your respective airlines for assistance. Sorry for the inconvenience. Now, which one is right? Sentence or right statements given in your book, page number 46.
Then I on.
No, give 2 minutes time, take on, then I will read it again, then we will finish the listening part, okay? Quickly. You also do. Read the question properly. Done. Okay. Wait for others. Here it is.
I know that in a listening we have to first listen the what the you are saying and then we have to do but my listening power is very less means somewhat I forgot some sentence I do with along with you speak
Okay, that's great. Good idea also. Okay, I'll be reading. The listening part again, but take 1 or 2 minutes time to complete the work so that you can correct it in the second listening. There are 6 questions, okay?
Ma'am, can you tell me what we have to do? I have read to it.
Okay. See, I had taken the listening test from page number 46 in your textbook. Open page number 46. Okay, the first question it has given of speaking, of the listening one, you have to listen that audio, whatever I'm going to read for you. After listening, you have to solve the task that has given. You have to take the correct one. I'm going to read for you again, those have joined right now. Yes. All of you listen very carefully. Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? We regret to inform you that the cyclonic weather in Bhubaneswar has caused several flights to get delayed. National Airlines Flight 999, Bhubaneswar to Kolkata, which was scheduled for departure at 7:30 from gate number A16, is now scheduled to depart at 10:30 from gate number A4. Sahara Airlines Flight 222, Bhubaneswar to Mumbai, scheduled for departure at 11:30 for gate number N8. Now scheduled to depart at 2 o'clock. Deccan Air Flight 555 New Delhi to Kolkata via Bhubaneswar is delayed by more than 5 hours. We will let you know the expectation time of arrival in short while. Please check the arrival departure boards for more specific information and update on individual flights. For passengers who will miss connecting flights, please go to the customer service desk of your respective airline for assistance. Sorry for the inconvenience. So this is your listening part. I hope you have listened it properly. After that, let's complete the task. Which one is right? We have to click on. Ma'am, the first question it is. Yes, better.
Yes, yes, you continue. I want to speak one of the answer.
So first sentence is, flight have been delayed due to cyclonic weather in Bhubaneswar. Tell me, it is right or wrong?
Ma'am, right.
Right.
Hmm?
Right. Okay, right. Tick. Now second was National Airline Flight 999 will fly from Kolkata to Bhubaneswar. Kolkata to Bhubaneswar. It is wrong because this announcement is from Bhubaneswar Airport. Bhubaneswar Airport means the flights, those are going from Bhubaneswar to other part. Okay, so it is totally wrong. Third one is Sahara Airlines flight 222 to Mumbai has been rescheduled to leave at 2 o'clock. Tell me, right?
Right, it is.
Right? How? It says the Sahara Airline flight 222 to Mumbai.
No, ma'am, because Sahara se, par ye to announcement Bhubaneswar se ho rahi hai na.
Yes, yes, very nice. Good, good. Janil, you are right. It is from Bhubaneswar to Mumbai. Okay, so it is also wrong.
It is given to Mumbai only. Ma'am, it is not given from Mumbai, it is given to Mumbai.
Listen, I'm going to read the same line of Sahara, okay, airline. Fine, give me one, yeah, listen carefully. Sahara Airlines flight 222, Bhubaneswar to Mumbai. So here Bhubaneswar is missing in this sentence, okay. Bhubaneswar to Mumbai scheduled for depart at 11:30 from gate number N8 is now scheduled to depart at 2 o'clock. Rest of the things are okay, but here not mentioned from where to where. Okay, only it has mentioned Mumbai, but it should be from Bhubaneswar to Mumbai, not 222 Mumbai. Okay, so that's why it is wrong. Now moving to next question. It is not known when Deccan Air Flight 555 will reach Bhubaneswar.
Wrong.
Deccan Air flight 555 New Delhi to Kolkata is so Kolkata via Bhubaneswar is delayed by more than 5 hours. Okay. So it is not known when Deccan flights will reach Bhubaneswar. More than 5 hours. We will let you know the expected time. That means they don't know really what would be the time of arrival or depart. Okay. So that's why they said or they announced that they will inform you later on. That means they don't know. So this statement is right. Answer question number 4, that is right. Now moving to next. Passengers need to get in touch with the customer service desk of their airline for updates on individual flights. True or false?
False, ma'am, false, because over here to get, it is not compulsory that to get with the customer service. Who missed a connecting flight, that only they have to do. I mean, second one, sixth one is right explanation to fifth one.
Yes, so fifth one is wrong and sixth one is right. You are correct. Okay, so the correct statements are question number 1, 4 and 6. Question number 1, 4 and 6. These are correct one. Okay? Got it all of you? Now we are going to move to the next part of this today's class, that we are going to discuss the summary of the chapter. Very quickly I will explain or read out the summary of the chapter. After that you are going to solve the think and answer from the chapter. There will be 6 questions. Okay? And all the answer has given in your textbook only. The things is that you have to search it. Okay? Give me 1 minute time to share the document. Yes, now I'm going to share screen. Let me turn off my camera so that we can have good connectivity. Yes. So this is the summary of the chapter Saving Chilika. Okay, I'm going to send you this in your what you call WhatsApp group, which
WhatsApp
is a, yes, I have already sent to you in WhatsApp. You can check it, okay, later on. Where is that? Okay. So here is the reading of lesson Saving Chilika, chapter number 4. Chilika is listening. You will learn how to write a short summary by yourself. Okay. So this is format of writing, or this is a sample of writing summary. So Chilika is the finest bird sanctuary in India. This unique half salt water and half fresh water lake is situated in Odisha, is 70 km in length and 30 km in breadth. In this lesson you will learn story about a man, Nandakishore, who killed a bird when he was a young boy. He felt guilty and decided to save an entire bird sanctuary. In 1981, Chilika was recognized as a Ramsar site for its ecological importance and rich biodiversity. In a matter of 10 years, all this changed. Chilika was tagged as a degraded site. This was because of a dual tragedy that struck Chilika firstly. There was the illegal catching or killing of animals. About 1,000 birds were killed every day by shooting, trapping in nets, by poisoning them with pesticides. And soon, the number of birds slowly became fewer. Around the same time, the mouth of the lake started narrowing down, so the amount of seawater entering the lake decreased due to the reduced salinity. Many freshwater weeds began to grow here, which in turn destroyed the vegetation of lake. When Nanda Kishore came back to Chilika, he saw that there were only few thousand birds left. He decided that he would do everything possible to save the birds. He talked to people in the neighboring village and came to know that the birds were killed by a group named Dirty Dozen, which was led by a man named Madhur Behra. Nanda Kishore met the member of group and explained them that they should stop doing such a cruel task. But the stubborn poacher paid no heed to him and warned that you should not interfere in our livelihood. Even after such a huge threat, Nanda Kishore refused to give up. He took support from the locals of that village. This made the poachers so angry and they threatened him to face consequences if he did not leave them alone. Instead of being afraid, he told them firmly that kill me, but stop killing these innocent birds. A week later, the Dirty Dozen reached Nanda Kishore's house and were completely changed. Nanda Kishore's words changed the Dirty Dozen's hearts and they pledged to save Chilika as well the flora and fauna there. Now, the poachers turned as the protectors of the environment.
Ma'am, this is made by you or anyone's side.
Why are you asking? You should listen whatever I am reading out, okay? We can talk later on also after reading this. Okay? Better see. We are your teacher so that we can consider you. But interfering in the midway, that is not good manner, okay? After completing something, you just ask your doubt. That could be, considered as good behavior. Okay, beta? Milan? Okay, Milan? Say yes or no. Now you are not replying. Okay, don't mind. I'm your teacher, that's why I'm just telling you. Otherwise, why should? Okay, moving to next. Thank you so much, beta, for your understanding. Okay, which line I was reading? Yeah, realize that the poachers had extensive knowledge about the birds. He decided to tape up their knowledge. He held workshops for them and trained them to become nature guides. Several organizations came forward to make Nanda Kishore's ecotourism effort more successful. The Chilika Development Authority provided equipment like binoculars and tents. Finally, in the year 2002, Chilika was removed from the red list. This is the only ecosystem in Asia to have ever come out of the dreaded list due to the selfless effort of Nanda Kishore. So this is all about the summary of the chapter. Now we are going to move to discuss think and answer from your textbook that I have that today we will discuss that. Summary you understand and all the answer has been given in your book only. Okay, you have to find it out. All of you open page number 43. Page number 43, opened, look, okay. So what is the first question is asking, what led to Chilika being listed as a degraded site?
मैम कैन आई? यस मैम, इन दिस वन द आंसर इज ए अपोचिंग एंड सेकेंड इज द migratory birds which are being killed by the poachers.
And
yeah ma'am, I have
okay, you have done
MCQ. Ma'am,
chilika being listed as a degraded site because of the rampant poaching. For example, such as the group of the Dirty Dozen, they are poaching the birds, they are poaching the migratory birds who are coming from the different countries to India to migrate, and by different ways, such as shooting them, catching them in nest, poisoning them with the pesticides. Well, the Nanda Kishore came. One day Nanda Kishore also shot an egret who was holding a twig. Nanda Kishore realized that the egret was holding the twig for the nest, for their eggs, etc. to build the nest.
The question is asking that what led Chilika being listed as degraded. So here you have to give reasons why it has been in the danger list. That means, okay, you understand. So you have to here put the point. The tragedy happened. There are two tragedy happened. First one is
rampant poaching.
Poachers. And the birds had been killed in different way. Okay, some of the reason are like they put poison like pesticide and all. Okay, trapping in nest, that all given. Now all of you search the answer in your book where it has given. Where is the answer in your book? Which page? Which paragraph?
Page number 39, third paragraph.
What is the meaning of mil gaya? Found.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, are we doing the page number 42, the MCQs? Because question number 1 is same as you spoke.
No, we are not doing question number, fill in the blanks of MCQ. Okay? We are doing page number 43. Answer in detail.
Hello, ma'am?
Okay. Yes. Yes.
Hello, ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, because there was a network problem, I was not able to join from start. It was coming that somebody removed you. Ma'am?
Okay. Yes, beta.
Ma'am, I was not able to join from start. It was continuously coming that somebody removed you. From start, it was continuously coming. Whenever I was trying to join.
But see, we are not doing anything. I am teaching. All how other cannot do anything. So maybe you have internet.
No, no, you are clearly showing me that somebody removed you from the meeting.
Where?
Ma'am, whenever I was joining, it was showing me that your meeting is ended and somebody removed you. And then it stops the app.
Which app, beta?
Ma'am, App City.
FCC? No, nobody is doing anything, okay? Now all of you find our question number first. In your textbook, where the answer has given?
Page number 39, paragraph 2 and 3.
Page number 39, paragraph 2 and 3. That's great. Yes, yes. You are right. You are right. Okay. Now moving to next question. How did Nandakishore try to pursue the Dirty Dozen to give up poaching? How did Nandakishore try to pursue the Dirty Dozen give up poaching?
Page number 40.
Tell me the answer. Page number 40 you understand, but tell me the answer. Which paragraph and what would be your answer?
Ma'am, Nandakishore met the members of the group and explained them why they should stop poaching the bugs, and that he also explained that the officials has put the lake under surveillance because it was in the red list, and instead of the poachers were not paying him heed to him, so he the poachers asked that you don't interfere. And one day when Madhu Behra come to Nandakishore's home to kill him, so he said, kill me if you must, but don't kill the birds because they have nowhere else to go. By these words, the Dirty Dozens were touched by these words of Nandakishore.
That's wonderful. Very good, very good. Okay, it would be a little long answer, right? So Nandakishore made the member of Dirty Dozen, okay, and who that group has been led by Madhu Behra. He explained everything, all the details, and asked them to stop poaching. He also given the reason why they should stop, okay, and also shared that if they will not stop, then maybe the forest officer or officers, they can arrest them or give them punishment, okay. So same, so many points he has mentioned to explain them or try to make them convinced, but they did not listen, okay. Then Madhu Behra, he decides, okay, sorry, he got angry and said that they will not obey him and he should not interfere in his work, okay. But a week later, Madhu Behra realized that Nandakishore was right in his way. So he came to Nandakishore home and said that they are also going to participate to save or protect Chilika Lake, okay. After that, what happened? They make a new group, you can say. They were only, how many members? It has mentioned, they were only 11, and now they are 50 in group, okay? So this thing you have to mention in question number 2, but in a proper way. Answer is in front of us. We have to find it out and do some modification, okay, modify your answer and write down, that's it. See? All the comprehensive answer you will get in the chapter only. So no need to search here and there. 2-3 are there that you have to think about. Okay, otherwise nothing. Give one instance of how the former poacher stood by their promise. Okay, where is the answer and what would be your answer? Tell me.
Can I?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes. Dirty dozens were very dirty and they have poached the lots of bird. They have stood by the Nandakishore's onward. They have stood by the promise ever since. When one of them broke the pledge, then he was expelled from the group and then handed over the forest officer and arrested the person who broke the pledge. And the team of 11 gradually become the 50. And the all are taking care of the Chilika Lake, and they ought to protect the Chilika Lake from again drowning into the red list.
Yes, wonderful, very nice, very nice, well done. So the answer we found the answer in our book only, okay, page number 40, last paragraph is your answer. But the changes you have to do in your answer, that is part of your job, right? How can you make your answer more, what you call, proper, you can say. Fine. Moving to next question. Why did Nandakishore decide to train Madhu Behra's team to become nature guides? How were they trained?
Ma'am, can I?
Yes.
Ma'am, the Nandakishore realized that the poacher had...
Yeah. You are saying, you got it? That is,
yes, ma'am.
See, that is proper noun. Okay? In proper noun, we don't use the.
Yes. Nanda Kishore realized that poachers were hunting the birds every day. They know that the knowledge of the migratory birds, when the some type of birds come in which particular season and which come in the autumn season, spring season and etc. And the which the migratory birds visit in a winter also. They could keep the track of the time of the bird starting coming and when they go back to their native place. He decided to tap their knowledge and he held a few days the workshop for the poachers to train them a natural guide so that the travelers which are coming to visit the Chilika Lake every winter, they can have a knowledge about which birds they see are. And they taught them the English name of this bird so that if the foreigner has come, then he can, means poacher can explain about the bird easily. And he has extended the poachers' communication skills, how to communicate with the traveler and how to become a nearby friendship. Done.
Yes. Done. Very nice. Okay. The answer it has
Ma'am,
given
can I
is
tell answer of this.
Yes, beta, no problem. Speak.
Okay, ma'am. Fourth one na ma'am.
Fourth one, yes.
He held workshop for the ex-poachers and trained them to become natural guides. They were taught the English names of these birds and they were also taught how to improve their communication skills, both of which were necessary if they had to interact with tourists and natural lovers. In this way, they were trained to be natural guides.
Okay, good try. Isha, anyone wants to change in this answer or add something? Sahil Isha, Monil Shah, Asta, everyone has to participate. Beta. Dharmi, Himanshi, Krishiv was participating earlier so much, okay, and now he stopped. Why Krishiv? What is your problem, beta? Krishiv, are you okay? Why don't you feel comfortable? Okay, ma'am, I'm not okay. Maybe because of internet issue, beta. Monil, do one thing: leave the meeting and rejoin. Okay, refresh your mobile and rejoin the meeting. It happens with me also. It's okay. Okay, moving to next question. How did the Chilika Development Authority, that CDA, develop and support ecotourism in Chilika? How did the Chilika develop? Yes, of course. You should ask by using the word may, okay? May I, ma'am? So this is permission.
Okay, ma'am. The Chilika Development Authority, CDA, gave them land to set up an office and an interpretation center. They also provide equipment like binoculars and tents. This is how they came forward to make Nanda Kishore's ecotourism efforts more successful.
Okay, that's great. You can mention that things also. They had also provided them some binoculars and tent house so that they can stay over there and take care of Chilika Lake. Okay. So, and they have also provided them some land so that they can build their office over, okay, that area, and they can work on Chilika Lake. Okay. That point also you can mention over there. Now moving to next question, what role did the former poachers play in bringing ecotourism to Chilika?
May I answer?
Yes, beta.
The poachers turned protectors, patrolled the waterways of Chilika. They took natural lovers around in their boats, as they knew the whereabouts of each species and provided food to the visitors. The ones with superior communication skills became guides. This is how the poachers and protectors helped bringing ecotourism to Chilika.
Very nice. Wonderful, Vivan. Vivan or Vihan? What's your name? Vihan, na? Yeah.
Vihan.
Wonderful answer. Thank you so much, beta. So what happened? The poachers turned protectors patrol the waterway of Chilika through boat and all. And they took nature lover around their boats as they knew where each species lived. They provided food to visitors. The one with good communication skill become the guide. Okay. So they taught them the communication skill. What happened, Milan? Why have you written ma'am three times? Do you have anything to say? Okay. So we have completed discussion of question answer in detail. Okay. Now next question we are going to discuss, that is think and answer. Okay. Think and answer before giving your answer. Clearly think, note it down all the points that you are elaborate on the change that Nanda Kishore brought about in the life of Dirty Dozen. Elaborate means explain. Okay, in detail. Elaborate on the change that Nanda Kishore brought about in the lives of the Dirty Dozen.
Ma'am, can I know full answer without seeing.
May I, ma'am?
Yes, everyone. I take 1 minute time to think about the discussion. Yes.
Can I?
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, that when Nanda Kishore thing, I saw that every day the birds which were coming, migratory birds which were coming to the Chilika Lake has been decreased. He thought for once while, but can't understand what is the reason. And then he go to nearby village. I don't know the name of village, but it was given in a passage. And at that place, the old villagers were telling that a group of poachers, nearby 15 to 20 members there were, and the men who were leading the Dirty Dozen was the Madhu Behra. And since Nanda Kishore realized that they were poaching the birds, so he met the member of the group and explained why should they stop the poaching the birds. And he also explained that the forest officer had made the lake under surveillance, and now it has been into red list, which is very dangerous. But the poachers...
See, listen. You have to understand the question is asking something particular. No need to explain extra things. That is the extra knowledge you are giving. You have to start your answer how Nanda Kishore changed the life of Dirty Dozen. That reason, that is to mention in the answer.
Means now the poacher, from here only the main answer starting, I think. Now, yes. Nanda Kishore go to the house of the Madhu Behra, and he has tell all what was the decreasing sight about the birds. But Nanda Kishore, Nanda Kishore and Madhu Behra do not listen to Nanda Kishore's idea. And then he said, you do not interfere in our job. It is our job to do and kill or poach the any birds for the eating purpose and for selling it. And they refused to, but the Nanda Kishore do not refuse to give up. But next day, the Madhu Behra and the all come with the dangerous weapons to kill them. But Nanda Kishore say one line, ma'am, I don't know that line, face. It was the face by which the heart of the Dirty Dozen were touched by that. And a week later, the Dirty Dozen were back to the Nanda Kishore's doorstep. And only this was the time when the Dirty Dozen had been transformed. And that pledge with the Nanda Kishore was... What, ma'am?
Yes, yes, continue.
Okay.
Continue, beta. Are you there?
Ma'am?
Yes, Agastya?
Ma'am?
Okay, I heard your answer, but ma'am, my laptop get hanged. It's automatic. Okay, fine, no problem.
Ma'am, I have lewd now, and there was one message that somebody removed from the meeting.
Who?
No, ma'am, there was no any name.
How is possible? I think host can only remove you.
Ma'am, but over here, when I leave, the like that session ended and all the host had no
maybe,
like that.
Because of network issue, it's going better. Because of network issue.
Okay.
Today we have done with our discussion part. Time also over. Okay. We'll go for the next. Beta, actually I have call from some VN class also over. Okay. So I will listen your answer definitely tomorrow. Fine. Okay. I'll remember. Okay. Or if I forget, please remind me. So I'll listen you tomorrow. All of you, I have already sent you the homework. Please do complete. Attendance will be taken already. Okay. Do complete your work on time. And complete it, submit me by Tuesday evening, not after that, okay? So you have 2 days time to record your video where you will speak about silica lake. This is your speaking test, okay? Bye all of you, take care.